If I could have advised the president or Donald Trump Jr., I would have said, go to Don McGahn. Don McGahn is a very, very competent lawyer who is the White House legal counsel and was the general counsel to the campaign. He would have said, you want to talk to an ex-KGB GRU agent and a Russian person represented as a Russian government lawyer, even though we now know she wasn't, about research on Hillary? Tell the FBI, don't bring those guys in here.
So had he taken it to a lawyer, that lawyer would have said no. Why? If it's not a crime, like Jay Sekulow is saying.
It is a crime to receive something of value when you are a campaign official from a foreign person or a foreign government. That may not be the best statute in the world, because you also have the freedom of speech to gather information from wherever you want. But when the Congress wrote the laws governing presidential campaigns, they said presidential campaigns cannot accept anything of value from a foreign person or a foreign government.
Wait, so hold on, rewind, because I know you were gone last week, so it's good to get your take on this, Judge. So you're saying had he, because Don Jr. walked away from this saying she didn't have any information, there was no information exchanged, they moved on to another topic. Had he actually received information, you're saying that would have been?
That would have been a felony. That would have been the completion of a crime. So when like John Sununu, Bill just did a great interview with former Governor Sununu, who kept saying, just as Jay Sekulow, who we all know, yesterday, where's the crime, where's the statute
Correct.
That they violated? Often, these nonviolent criminal events don't happen all at once. They happen in stages. So the question is this enough to commence a criminal investigation? Answer, yes, because it is suspicious that they met with these people, that they didn't consult a lawyer, and that one of these people is a former KGB GRU, that's the Russian intelligence arm, Russian military intelligence arm, and didn't tell anybody about it. Why didn't Jared Kushner tell the FBI about
it
when he filled
out
his FBI national security application, unless he was trying to hide something? And if he was trying to hide something, was it that this was a bumbling, foolish thing to do, or that this was the beginning of some steps in furtherance of acquiring this information?
And it is important.